हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे विल डिस्कस द फीमेल रिप्रोडक्टिव सिस्टम। फीमेल रिप्रोडक्टिव सिस्टम कंसिस्ट ऑफ ओवरीज, ओविडक्ट और फेलोपियन ट्यूब्स, यूट्रस, वेजाइना, रिप्रोडक्टिव ग्लैंड्स, एक्सटर्नल जेनिटेलिया, मेमरी ग्लैंड्स। सो फीमेल रिप्रोडक्टिव सिस्टम कंसिस्ट ऑफ ओवरीज, ओविडक्ट और फेलोपियन ट्यूब्स, यूट्रस, वेजाइना, रिप्रोडक्टिव ग्लैंड्स, एक्सटर्नल जेनिटेलिया and memory glands. In this diagram, I have shown the female reproductive system. It consists of fallopian tubes, inverted pear-shaped uterus, cervix, vagina. Fallopian tubes are differentiated into three parts: infundibulum, ampulla, and isthmus. These are fallopian tubes. Fallopian tubes are connected with ovary. Egg is released by the ovary and it is catched by the fimbriae of infundibulum. Fimbriae are the finger-like projections which are coming out from the infundibulum. So, female reproductive system consists of one pair of ovaries. These are almond-shaped fallopian tubes. Fallopian tube has infundibulum, ampulla, wide portion and a narrow portion, isthmus, which leads into the uterus. Uterus leads into cervix, which leads into vagina. Uterus is protected by, covered by three membranes: perimetrium, myometrium and endometrium. Perimetrium is protective in nature. Myometrium is made up of smooth muscles which help in contraction during parturition or childbirth. And endometrium is the innermost lining of the uterus, and the thickness of the endometrium never remains constant. Uterus leads into cervix, which encloses cervical canal. It leads to vagina, which encloses vaginal canal. Cervical canal plus vaginal canal together form birth canal. Cervical canal plus vaginal canal together form the birth canal. So we will study each and every structure one by one. Ovary is a solid structure. Ovary is filled with a tissue called stroma. This almond shaped ovary is filled with a tissue called stroma. The peripheral outer cortex, the peripheral portion of the ovary is called cortex, and the inner portion is known as medulla. Like testes, ovary is also lined by germinal epithelium, which is cuboidal in nature and which give rise to gametes, that is egg. Attached to the wall of the uterus, ovary is attached to the wall of the uterus through ligaments. Ovary is attached to the wall of the uterus through ligaments. Next is fallopian tubes. The first part of the fallopian tube is infundibulum, which is in contact with the ovary. Infundibulum is cup-like structure with finger-like projections and has an aperture called ostium. See, I have shown you in the last diagram, finger-like projections in which are known as fimbriae. This is infundibulum cup-like structure, and infundibulum has an aperture in between called ostium. Through this ostium, egg enters from the ovary into the fallopian tubes. Egg is released from the ovary in secondary oocyte stage, which we will discuss later on. So, infundibulum is a cup-like structure with finger-like projection and has an aperture called ostium in the middle. The secondary oocyte is caught by the fimbriae and put into the ostium. So, the secondary oocyte or egg is caught by the fimbriae and put into the ostium, which leads into ampulla. Infundibulum leads into ampulla. Ampulla is the broader region. Next is isthmus. Isthmus is the narrow region. Site of fertilization is ampullary isthmic junction. In new NCRT, it is written that site of fertilization is ampulla. So you can write ampulla as well as ampullary isthmic junction. So once fertilization occurs, the zygote forms formed moves towards the uterus. If fertilization occurs, then the zygote form will move towards the uterus. Otherwise also, if the egg remains unfertilized, it moves to the uterus. Fallopian tubes are lined by ciliated epithelium. And they are made up of smooth muscles whose contraction pushes the egg or fertilized zygote towards the uterus. So, wall of fallopian tube comprises of ciliated epithelium and smooth muscle. Their action helps in moving, dividing embryo towards the uterus. If the zygote is formed, then it will start dividing. So, dividing embryo towards the uterus or unfertilized egg towards the uterus. The other name for the uterus is womb. It is an inverted pear-shaped structure. It is organ in which fetus develops. Embryo is implanted and fetus undergoes development in the uterus. So, in uterus, embryo is implanted and fetus gets developed. Wall of the uterus has three layers. Outermost layer is called perimetrium, which is simply peritoneum, which is made up of simple squamous epithelium. All internal organs are lined by peritoneum. For example, you have studied in heart, lungs, they are lined by parietal peritoneum and visceral peritoneum. So, outer layer is called perimetrium, which is simply peritoneum, simply squamous epithelium. Middle layer is myometrium, which is made up of smooth muscles. Muscular layer having smooth muscles. Endometrium is innermost layer and the diameter of the or thickness of the endometrium is never constant. Next is cervix. Neck of the uterus is called cervix. It has strong muscular sphincter. Cervix encloses cervical canal. Cervical canal opens in vagina. Vagina is a narrow structure where there is a lining of stratified non-keratinized squamous epithelium. Vaginal canal plus cervical canal forms the birth canal. Vaginal canal plus cervical canal together form the birth canal. No glands are present in the vaginal canal. Opening of vagina, that is vaginal orifice, is covered by a perforated membranous structure called hymen. See, this is important. Opening of vagina or vaginal orifice is covered by a perforated membranous structure called hymen. This hymen ruptures during sexual intercourse or during sternus exercise. Vagina opens into the external genitalia or vulva. Two openings are present in the vulva. One is urethral opening and other is vaginal opening. Urethral opening is for the passage of urine and vaginal opening is for insemination, that is for the transfer of sperms and for childbirth. So, vaginal opening and urethral openings are separate in case of female reproductive system, whereas in case of male reproductive system, both openings are same. There is only one opening which acts as urethral as well as for the release of semen. Now, this is the structure of external genitalia in case of female. See, this fat deposition over pubic bones, this area is known as mons pubis. It is generally covered by hair. There are two fold of lips. Upper portion is known as labia majora and inner fold is known as labia minora. These are thick lip-like folds. Labia majora is homologous to, scrotum in males. Inner thin lip-like fold is labia minora. This labia minora encloses a space called vestibule. This whole space is called vestibule, and this vestibule has two openings. Upper one is urethral opening and lower one is vaginal opening. The space between the external genitalia and anus is known as perineum. It is also known as perineum. So, external genitalia consist of mons pubis. It is the fat deposition over pubic bones in the pelvic area. Hair growth are present. Beneath mons pubis, two lip-like folds are present. One is labia majora and second is labia minora. Labia majora is thick lip-like folds. They are homologous to scrotum in males. What are homologous organs? Which are similar in origin but different in function. They show divergent evolution. Labia minora. They are thin lip-like folds inner to majora. Vestibule. It is the narrow space between the labia minora, or the space present between the labia minora is known as vestibule. In vestibule, two openings are present, vaginal opening and urethral opening. The place where the two labia minora meet, see here, I'll show you it again here. The place where two labia minora meet, a special structure is formed which is known as clitoris. This structure is known as clitoris, and this clitoris is homologous to penis in males. This clitoris is homologous to penis in males. So clitoris homologous to male penis. It is formed by joining of labia minora at the anterior end. Here spongy tissue forms a finger-like structure called clitoris. A finger-like structure called clitoris is formed where the two ends of the labia minora meet on the anterior side. Tip of clitoris is highly excitable, therefore it is also known as glans clitoridis. It is highly excitable, therefore it is also known as glans clitoridis, covered by foreskin. It is covered by foreskin. On the lateral side of the vaginal opening, a gland is present called Bartholin's gland or vestibular gland. This is very important. On the lateral side of vaginal opening, a gland is present called Bartholin gland or vestibular gland. This vestibular gland is homologous to Cooper's gland of males. Therefore, it also helps in lubrication. It helps in lubrication. Next is mammary glands. Mammary glands are present in mammals, and this is the main characteristic of mammalian female. Most characteristic feature of mammals, present in all females without exception. It produces milk to nourish the newborn babies. But the location of mammary gland varies in different mammals. For example, mammary glands are thoracic in humans, they are abdominal in cows, and both thoracic and abdominal, example in rats. So here I have shown the sectional view of the mammary gland. These are the ribs and the muscle which attaches the mammary gland to the thoracic region is pectoralis major. Mammary glands consist of sac-like structure called alveoli. In which milk is formed or milk is secreted by the alveoli. This milk is then passed on to the mammary tubules. They are passed on to the mammary tubule, then to mammary duct, then to ampulla, lactiferous duct, and it is passed to the open. It is released outside. So mammary gland has alveoli. Alveoli leads into mammary tubules. Mammary tubules lead to mammary duct, ampulla, lactiferous duct, and to the outside. So mammary glands are modified sweat glands. This question is frequently asked in exams, ki mammary glands are modified sweat glands or sebaceous glands. They are modified sweat glands. These are apocrine in nature. What is apocrine glands? Which loses some part with the secretion. See, this is the portion which is secreting, this is the cell which is secreting milk. milk is accumulated here and a portion of the cell is also released with the milk. In egg-laying hormonal control of mammary glands. How the mammary glands are controlled? How milk secretion is controlled? See, progesterone is responsible for the development of secretory cell. These secretory cells are developed with the help of hormone progesterone. Estrogen is responsible for the development of mammary duct. This mammary duct is developed with the help of estrogen. Fat deposition over the mammary glands is also done by the estrogen. Fat deposition is also done by the estrogen. HPL, this is human placental lactogen secreted by the placenta. This is a temporary hormone. It is secreted only during pregnancy. Human placental lactogen secreted by placenta during pregnancy, it enlarges the mammary glands. Prolactin. Prolactin is secreted by pituitary gland and it is responsible for the synthesis and secretion of milk. It is responsible for synthesis and secretion of milk. Which hormone? Prolactin hormone. It is secreted by pituitary gland. Oxytocin. Oxytocin helps in ejection of milk. It helps in the release of milk. It is synthesized in hypothalamus and released from the pituitary. So, it is synthesized by pituitary gland, but it is synthesized by the hypothalamus, but it is released by pituitary gland. So, with this, we finish with the female reproductive system.